guys, I'm Mad Chen and I'm a digital artist. I'll be creating a series of Procreate tutorials to show you how to use this app to your advantage. In this first video, we're going to be covering the basics of how to use Procreate. Even for those of you who have been using Procreate for a while, there might be some of these techniques that I can show you that you haven't discovered yet. So stick around and I'll show you these basic features in just a few moments. Welcome back, guys. So let's get straight into the basic Procreate features. The first feature that I'd like to show you is called the undo, which does exactly what its name suggests. As an example, we have this image here on the screen. And let's say I accidentally draw a green line over the top. So how do we delete this green line? What you can do is take two fingers and tap once on the screen, which will delete the green line. The second basic Procreate feature shows you how to snap the canvas back to its original size, like so. In Procreate, when you're using the canvases, you actually have the ability to adjust the size of your canvas, or you can twist and turn it to make it easier for you to work with. At some point though, you'd want to see an overall view of your art piece. So you could enlarge it like this to see everything as it is, or you could do it the Procreate way, which is taking two fingers and just pinch the screen once, where your art piece, your canvas, will snap back into its original size and place. The third basic Procreate feature shows you how to get your canvas on full screen mode without the toolbar on the top or on the side. So how do we do this? All you have to do is take four fingers and tap once on the screen to get it into full screen mode. Now to get the tools back, just tap again with four fingers. The fourth basic Procreate feature shows you how to delete recent multiple mistakes at one time. So let's say, for example, I draw a couple of green shapes like a square, a star, a circle, and let's put a line over here. Now I want to delete these green shapes. All you have to do is take three fingers and shake a bit on the screen, which will get rid of all these green shapes for you, like so. The fifth basic Procreate tip includes using three fingers. So let's take these three fingers and swipe down, which brings up this menu for copy and paste. So now you can cut, copy, copy all, duplicate, cut and paste, or paste any image or painting that you've done. The sixth basic Procreate tip that I have for you is how to open up the eyedropper tool. The eyedropper tool allows you to choose a color within any image. Let me show you what I mean. So you can do this with one finger, and all you have to do is choose a color. So let's say we want this pink up here. All we have to do is point, and it'll open up this magnifying glass to allow you to see exactly which color you'd like to select. So let's say we want this nice pink here, and we just let go. And now you have pink, the exact same pink. For the seventh basic Procreate tip, I will show you how to get a saturated color from the color wheel. The color wheel is located on the top right hand corner of the screen, where this circle is. So let's click on this once to open up the color wheel. As you can see, we're on blue, but you can use any color that you wish. But for now, for this example, let's use red. So we'll use red as an example. So I would like to get a saturated red. How do we do that? All you have to do is go to the red section and double tap. Now Procreate will automatically choose a saturated red for you. The same goes if you wanted a saturated black, just double tap. A saturated gray, or a saturated white. You can do this for all the colors. The eighth basic Procreate feature shows you how to use the quick shape tool. Now let's say, for example, I want to draw a circle, and let's say that I'm not very good at drawing circles. So I'm going to attempt to draw a circle here as an example. You can see that lines are not very straight, so it's not looking like a good circle right now. But if I hold my pen in place, the shape snaps into a much better one. So this is looking like an oval at the moment, but how do we get this into the perfect circle that we're talking about? All you have to do is take one finger and hold on the screen, and it automatically snaps into a perfect circle shape. The quick shape tool can also be used for other shapes such as squares, triangles, and even straightening your lines. They're also movable, but if you hold your finger down on this line here, it can adjust the degrees for you. The ninth basic Procreate tip that I have for you is how to use the eraser tool on the toolbar. So let's say you're painting away. Let's just do this as an example. And we want to delete something. So now we're going to click on the eraser tool. Now this eraser tool mirrors and matches whatever brush that you're using. So for example, the brush that I'm currently using is a dry ink for this example. When I click the eraser tool is also the dry ink brush. So you can start erasing with the dry ink brush. The 10th basic Procreate tip that I have for you is how to get the exact size for your brush. So as you can see on the left hand side here, we have a toolbar for the brush size and also for your opacity. So as an example, I'll show you. If I put my pen on here, you can see that you can adjust the brush size as I move this up and down like so. But sometimes it makes it difficult to see because your pen and your hand are in the way, so you can't get the exact size that you want. So a good tip of avoiding that problem is to, once again, hold your pen down and then just drag a bit to the right side so that you can easily see everything now, and then you can choose the percentage that you want. The same goes for the opacity. What you need to do is just click, just hold it down, and then drag to the right side, and then that way you can see the percentages more clearly without having your pen or your hand in the way. The 11th basic Procreate feature that I want to show you is how to merge all of your layers into one. So how we're going to do that is we're going to go to the top right hand corner of the screen here where these tiny boxes are, and we'll click once to open up the layers section. Now what you need to do is just take two fingers and pinch everything together to turn it into one layer. But before I do that, I want to quickly mention that these boxes on the side here need to all be checked or ticked to make sure that all of your artwork is showing. So for example, if I uncheck this layer here and I pinch everything together, then this piece of artwork will not be showing in your final piece. So just make sure that you have all of your boxes checked on the layers that you want to be showing. All right, so now let's pinch them together. And now it's all in one layer. The 12th basic Procreate feature that I'd like to show you is how to select a lot of layers. All you need to do is swipe left to right on each layer that you'd like to select. Okay guys, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the basic Procreate features that I've shown you today. Please subscribe for future videos as I'll be making content for beginners up to advanced level. So also don't forget to hit that notification bell to be notified of upcoming videos. It would also be appreciated if you gave a like to this video to show your support. And you can also leave a comment below to let me know what kind of tutorials you'd like to see next. Alright guys, so I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next Procreate tutorial video. Bye!